How's it going, YouTube? Today we're gonna find out, is Capture One really that much better than Lightroom when editing Fujifilm files? Giving you guys a little bit of background, I've been shooting Fujifilm for 3 or 4 years now. I've really liked it, and I've used Lightroom for majority of that time. In the past 6 months or so, I've started using Capture One. I saw people online talk about that it's better for editing Fujifilm picture files, raw files specifically, and I decided to give it a try, and I was kind of blown away at first. And so I really like Capture One now, but I haven't totally switched from Lightroom for a few reasons. And so we're gonna edit a few pictures, 3 pictures that I picked out of my my catalog, and we're gonna go through those, edit them both in Lightroom and Capture One. So this might be a little bit long of a video, but if you're wondering about this, this will give you the answers whether, you know, Lightroom's better than Capture One, or is Capture One really that much better? Does it make a difference? So edit these pictures with me, and we can talk about it as we go. Tabs from the future here. So taking a break from editing this video, it doesn't make a ton of sense to have the actual editing process of both Lightroom and Capture One in this video. It was just making it a little too bloated. So I'm gonna take that out. I'm gonna make a separate tutorial on how to use Capture One. And I'm just gonna skip to the end of this video where the conclusion is at. So you're gonna see the side-by-side between Lightroom and Capture One, Fujifilm raw files edited in both of those programs, and my conclusion. So we're gonna jump to that point in the video. And if you're interested in a Capture One editing tutorial, how to use Capture One, you can follow the link in the description once I get it finished. Cool, we're just gonna jump right back into the video. We finished editing the files in both programs. I've exported them, and then I've brought them into Photoshop so that way you can see the difference. I put them side by side. I'm gonna go back and forth so that way you can see, here's the Lightroom picture and here is the Capture One picture. What are the differences? Primarily, you're gonna be looking at sharpness and what we're gonna define as worminess with Fujifilm pictures in Lightroom. So we'll show you that right now. We're gonna start here with the picture of me on the right here. You've got the picture of me from Lightroom, and on the left, it's the picture of me from Capture One. We're gonna zoom in right here real close. Here is my head, my jacket. What we're gonna be doing is we're gonna be looking here at detail. This is the definition of the Fujifilm worminess that you're gonna hear when people talk about editing pictures in Lightroom or Photoshop. You get this weird, I'll zoom in really close. This is unrealistically close, but you get this weird layer. It looks choppy on transition. You can see here on my eyebrow, the edge of my nose here, my eyeball. You can see it's light, dark, light, dark, light, dark, light, dark. There's a weird thing happening that when Adobe products are interpreting Lightroom or Fuji files, it does this. I'll show you here on the Capture One file the difference. So now we're on the Capture One file. We're gonna zoom in, and you would argue the fact that this was taken, you would probably argue the fact that this picture was taken on a different camera, but it's the same exact camera, everything. It's the same file. It's just edited in Capture One. This is the main reason why I've started using Capture One more than Lightroom. Is look at this. You get it's a totally different picture. You can see the detail in my skin. Now, some may argue that you don't want that much detail on the skin. It's at least good to have, so you can take it away if needed. Okay, but here you go. We're gonna zoom in here on my ear. Look at no weird stepping from light to dark. My eye, no weird stepping light to dark. It's just clean. Okay, we're gonna. I also copied my head over here, so that way you can see a good side-by-side of what we're talking about. You've got this weird chunkiness going on in my hair that is not there over here on this side of the image. Capture One, Lightroom. Capture One on the left, Lightroom on the right. Again, we'll zoom in real quick here on the nose and the eyeball, see what's going on. It's a clean image. Scroll over here, and you got this weirdness going on. You even have this weirdness here on the transition on the background that is clearly not here either. we're gonna switch files now. So that's the picture of me. We're gonna jump in here on the picture of this married couple. Few things to note here. His jacket, if you see his jacket, it's like a light faded gray now versus black. The detail, you can see his hair is just chunky like that. And then you also got that weird stepping going on. You even have the transitional spaces going here in that weird stepping that I was talking about, or worminess that people are talking. Her skin, you can definitely see it. You can see it a lot here on her face. And down here on her arm, I'll show you this. That's the Lightroom file. This is the Capture One file. So you can already tell, looks significantly cleaner. His jacket is back to being almost black. You don't have any of the weird stepping. You can see the detail of the hem here, surprisingly. His hair is not nearly as chunky and just squished together. I don't know why it does that. Her face, you got none of that weird transitional period. Now, you may argue the fact that, why are you even talking about this? Because you're not going to zoom in to 250% at all. Well, it matters if you want to make a big 60 by 48 print. Because they're going to see that weird stepping once you start printing that big. People like printing big now. That's the thing. And so if you're taking pictures and you're delivering them this, you know, that's all clumpy, it's going to look more like someone applied some weird paint filter in Photoshop than an actual picture of them once blown up huge. Now we will do the last picture here, which is the picture of... Oh, I keep turning the wrong things here. Where'd it go? Oh, this one. Picture here of my wife, Kayla. Surprisingly, this one is... You don't really notice that much. I think the reason why I don't notice it that much is because I don't have a primary person as the subject. It's this ice cream cone. So this is the Capture One file that we're going to be looking at first. You can see the detail here around her fingernails, the detail in all of the sprinkles. I was going to call them sparkles. Yeah, pretty good image. You scroll over here to the Lightroom file, and it's not as sharp. You can tell here you're getting some kind of weird noise going on in the background. It's not nearly as smooth as this one. It's a little bit more grainy, but overall, it's not too bad. So if you're doing something that I guess maybe is not a person or pretty evenly lit, you're not going to know that big of a difference. But it's a big enough difference for me that in smaller work that I'm doing and smaller project work that I'm doing it all in Capture One now. I'm editing all my sharpening, everything in Capture One, and then any big compositing or like photo retouch work, I'm moving it into Photoshop. And I'm not adding any sharpening or any, I'm not doing really any photo effects in Photoshop besides removing objects, changing background, stuff like that. I do all of my basic photo editing done in Lightroom, and I export it as a TIFF, bring it into Photoshop. Okay, so those are the big differences that you're going to face when editing a picture in Capture One versus Lightroom. Is when you do it in Capture One, you edit a picture there, you don't worry about any of that weird artifacting that's going on. I don't know what's up with Lightroom and Photoshop and Adobe, but they should fix this. Fujifilm is becoming a much more prominent camera company. I had understood 3 or 4 years ago when I started with them that this was a problem, but still today, 2020, and Adobe treats these files like they shouldn't exist. I don't understand. Capture One has been great, and I really enjoy using it. There's been a couple weird things that I've run into with using it. If you have any questions about it, leave them down below. I could use those to make a video idea, but actually make a video based off of your suggestions. But if you're wondering if you should start using Capture One, if you're a Fujifilm shooter, I would 100% recommend it. Your pictures actually come out looking like pictures instead of glorified paintings. So start using it. I believe there's a free trial. I'll link the free trial below. I'm not an affiliate for Capture One at all. I've just enjoyed using the software, and that's why I'm making this video, because I think Adobe should be stepping it up, because they're just treating Fujifilm people like they don't exist. So Capture One is the way to go if you're using Fujifilm. If you're using other cameras like Canon, Nikon, I don't know if there's that big of a difference. I'm not using those camera systems right now heavily, so I'm primarily Fujifilm. So if you're a Fujifilm shooter, switch, download the free trial, whatever. It's gonna be a headache because I know you've been editing photos in Lightroom for the existence of time, but it's worth trying. Try something new. Let me know your thoughts. I appreciate your time, and I hope this video helped you a ton. Hit that like button, and I'll see you in the next video.